Hi guys, good morning. This is Pawan. Welcome to CID. Today we are going to cover part 2 of the chapter multi-threading. We have discussed in part 1 what is process states and the process control block. In this video we will cover what is thread and multi-thread and advantages of thread and disadvantages of thread. And in the last video we will learn about the threading module. So let's begin. What is thread? A thread is a lightweight sub-process. You can assume a thread as a part of a process. Suppose it's a kite and it can only be controlled by this one thread. No any other thread can control this kite at the same time. And if it can be controlled by another thread, then this thread must be stopped. It is the smallest unit of processing, because we have studied that thread is only a part of the process, except that it exists entirely inside a process and shares all the resources inside the process. A single process may have multiple threads of execution. Like, you can assume this is a process. Maybe this basket is a process and it has multiple threads, like thread 1, thread 2, thread 3, etc. inside this process. And all these threads will be independent of each other, but they can be able to share any type of data to each other. It is useful when an application wants to perform many concurrent tasks on shared data. Suppose you have given a task to draw a landscape. Then what will be your process? Your process will be to draw some trees, some grasses and some flowers, and also sky or mountain, etc. Then suppose draw tree is a method and draw grass 1, draw grass 2 are another two methods, and flower 1, 2, flower n, these are also some methods, and sky and mountain are also some methods. Then you can suppose these as one thread and control as a thread. Suppose this is a thread 1, this is thread 2, thread 3 and thread 4. Then all these are independent of each other, because it is drawing a tree and it is drawing sky and mountain. But they can be able to share some same type of data. Suppose this is drawing a tree and this tree is to be used in thread 4 in drawing the mountain. This thread will print some trees over the mountain. So the thread 4 will ask the thread 1 for tree, and this will share some data. Maybe flower is sharing here, maybe grasses are sharing here. Then you can understand that each thread can share some data to each other, and this will be permanent to each other. Think about a browser. Suppose a browser which has some pages and also some animations or hover effects, hyperlinks, etc. And if you are going to that web page, you are able to see some animations, and these have some pages and some hyperlinks. When you click on hyperlinks, they go to another, and all these processes are independent of each other. Multi-threading is a process of executing multiple threads simultaneously. Suppose loading some pages and animation or hover effects, etc. are multiple threads, then you can run all these threads concurrently. And if you are running all the threads concurrently, it is called multi-threading. Now let us understand what are the advantages of thread. Multi-threaded programs can run faster because of all the threads are being run at same time. This will save our time in executing whole the program. It allows us to do something else when one thread is waiting for some input output task. Suppose you have given a question to print your name and number up to 10. Then what will be your answer? Your answer may be like this: name equal to input, enter your name, and for I in range 1 to 11, print I. And then suppose you are here in this line and you are taking some time to type your name. Then processor is free to do something else. Then suppose you have given this one line as thread 1 and these two lines as thread 2. Then if you are in this line to type your name, then processor is free to do this thread 2 to be completed. And it is printing 1 to 10. Suppose you have typed your name and at that time it has printed only up to 6 and you have entered your name, then your name will be accessed firstly and then it will print 7, 8, 9, 10, etc. So some programs are easy to express using concurrency because maybe they are sharing the solutions, they are sharing the data to each other, then there may be helpful with concurrency. If they will run as concurrent time, then there may be easy to maintain them and debug. It is useful when application wants to perform many concurrent tasks on shared data. Threads of a process can share the memory of global variables. Because these are sharing global variables, then the global variable will be valid for all threads as same. But a local variable for any thread will not be affected by another threads. This will be safe. Let us understand what are the disadvantages of thread. First is scheduling. To execute a threaded program must rapidly switch between threads. This will be a problem that if you are running a threaded program, then you will have to switch all the threads time to time. This can be done by both user level threads and kernel level threads. We will understand this in next video. Next is resource sharing. Because threads sharing memory and other resources, then you will have to be very careful because one thread can share data to another thread and it will affect your program. Operation performed in one thread could cause problem in another because they are sharing memory and also some data. Then there may be problem in your program. Next is synchronization. Threads often need to coordinate actions. All the threads will have to coordinate to each other for running program smoothly. It can get race condition because they are sharing or accessing same type of data and same data at concurrent time. This can get race condition and your outcome will be dependent on order of thread execution. Often need to use locking primitives. You will have to use some locking system or semaphores, etc. We will understand these how to use locks and semaphores in our next video, and that will be the last video. We will use threading module in Python in the next video. So stay tuned. I will upload next to this as soon as possible. If you are new to our channel, then please do subscribe this channel so that you will have notifications about new videos as well. And if you like this video, then don't forget to share this video to your social media account so that your friends will also be get benefited. Thanks for watching.